Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to conduct lecture number 34, and in this lecture we will learn how to calculate the values for timer 0H and timer 0L registers for specific required delay. So let's see what we have in this topic for us to understand. Okay, let's say we want to calculate or we want to produce amount of delay with timer zero about 3 milliseconds, and we want to calculate the values for timer zero H and timer zero L registers for this specific delay of 3 milliseconds. And let's say we have given with the crystal oscillator that 4 megahertz crystal oscillator is attached with our Brigadier-EF microcontroller. So we have to we need to follow certain steps, and that steps we're going to learn. So first of all, we need to calculate the instruction frequency. Okay, so instruction frequency can be calculated using the formula we have already learned in the earlier lectures, that it is dependent on the crystal oscillator, and crystal oscillator we have given is 4 megahertz. So instruction frequency would be equal to 1/4 of crystal oscillator, that is XTEL divided by 4. So 4 megahertz divided by 4 would become 1 megahertz. So our instruction frequency would become 1 megahertz. Then we will calculate time of one instruction, or instruction time. So instruction time is equal to reciprocal of instruction frequency, which is 1 over frequency of instruction. So 1 over 1 megahertz would become equal to 1 microsecond. So now time of one instruction required for this delay is 1 microsecond. And how you can calculate the total count which should be counted or which should be repeated by timer, that is calculated using the required delay divided by time of instruction. So required delay in our case is 3 milliseconds, and time of one instruction is 1 millisecond. So if you calculate this thing become equal to 300, which is equal to 3000. So now we want to actually count up to around 3000 times, and you know that timer zero is basically 16-bit counter. It can be operated in 8-bit, so you know, if you remember that in 8-bit it can go up to FF in hexadecimal, which is equal to 255 in decimal, right? And if you operate it in hexadecimal, it can actually count up to 4 times F, which is equal to how many in decimal? It will be equal to 65,535. So since in 16-bit mode, you can actually use this count easily. You know that in 8-bit mode, we can't use it, but in 16-bit mode, you can easily count it. So this is the valid time count or timer count. Now we have to use a formula. So let me write the formula. Okay, this is the formula that one has to use, the initial values for timer, right? So what is the formula? You have to subtract the count that you have evaluated in this formula, right? So maximum count minus this count or this timer count plus one. And here we come to a question how this formula is derived. So if you remember, in last lecture, we actually started our timer where we were learning the basic steps of timer programming. So we started our code, or we initiated our timer value with this value, FFT, right? Then what it was converted to FE, right? And then it converted it to 4 times F, and then it becomes to reset. I'm not considering these higher significant bytes. I hope you remember it. So if you count these iterations, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So there were 3 counts involved, right? This is the same count that we are talking about here in this formula, right? So if you pay your attention, the maximum value, this is the maximum value, this is the count 3. So if you minus this count from this maximum value, we will eventually arrive to this value. And there will be one more point, which is called rollover transition. So that is why plus one is indicated here in this formula, right? So this formula is derived from this rollover concept. So you can actually derive using this formula from your previous basic steps of timer. But if you don't want to derive it, you can just memorize it. So what is the formula? You need to subtract your timer count, which you have evaluated in above formula, required delay divided by time of one instruction. So what you have to do, you have to subtract that count from the maximum count and plus one. And remember, this plus one comes from the rollover fact, right? So 65,535, this is the maximum count in decimal, and count which we have to produce using this timer is 3000 plus one of this formula. So if you do this calculation, it will become equal to 62,536. And remember, we have to convert it into hexadecimal, because timer 0H and timer 0L, we have to put their individual values. So to convert it into hexadecimal, we have to convert it into hexadecimal, right? So if you consider the same thing in hexadecimal, so 65,535 is the decimal value, but in hexadecimal, it becomes 4 times F, 3000, which was the count. So I converted it into hexadecimal, it becomes BBR. So 4 times F minus BBR plus one of this rollover, then the overall sums up equals to F448. And now these are the basically initial values for timer. Or when we say initial values for timers, so this is the higher significant byte and this is the lower significant byte. So this will go to timer 0L and this will go to timer 0H. So that's how you actually calculate the values of timer 0H and timer 0L. Let me write it for you. So F4 will be the value of timer 0H and 48 will be the value of timer 0L. And once you evaluated this value, so you can actually calculate, you can actually write down the program for timer 0, which will be producing 3 milliseconds. So hopefully you have understand the overall evaluation of these values procedure. If you have any confusion, you can post your confusions or queries in comment section. Okay, that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much for listening.